is a little bit of mist and maybe some more rain in the offing for us this evening. Welcome to the Sanctuary Brass. This organization started in 1968 with five freshmen, two from the medical school and three freshmen from the dental school. Five members of brass quintet started in 1968. 40 years ago, it became the resident brass ensemble of the university church. And that's about the time that I met Virgil Nielsen. I asked Virgil what he wanted me to say. He says, well, we've known each other for 40 years. I said, yeah, but we can't tell all of that. So it suffices to say we've known each other for 40 years. And there are still, there's one member of the brass ensemble, and I'm going to embarrass him because I know him very well. Kimber Schneider, would you please stand? Kimber was one of the original five freshman students in 1968 who founded this organization. Joining them, and I think also the just about the longest member next to Kimber is Dennis Anderson. Dennis, would you please stand? And you'll hear more from Virgil, but I've known these two gentlemen for 40 years, and we still speak to each other. So I want to thank you all for coming, both here in the sanctuary and at home via LLBN and television and online. Let us pause for just a moment for prayer, and then we'll let the guys take over, the guys and girls take over. Almighty God, you've given your children power to invent instruments of music and skill to use them in sending forth your praise. Grant that the music heard today in this, thy house, may kindle a spirit of devotion in us, your servants, so that we, taking our part in prayer and praise to thee here on earth, may hereafter be admitted to thy heavenly temple and join the everlasting songs of the redeemed around your throne. We pray all these things through our Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. The Sanctuary Brass. Thank you.
Thank you for coming and sharing this afternoon with us. The first piece we played is actually not originally a brass piece, but it's most often heard as a brass arrangement because of the loud and the soft contrast that you hear lends itself very well to brass. It was originally written as a keyboard piece, but it's heard mostly, as I said, now as a brass, and it's the contrast that you hear. The next piece that we're going to play is a piece by Gabrielli. This also has contrast, but it is characterized by now two different groups of brass players. So brass group on your right, brass group on your left, and play back and forth. So not only do they have the louds and the soft, but now they have the spatial separation as well. Is a little bit of a change of pace. It is a piece that was not originally written for brass. The composer is Johann Sebastian Bach, and I'm not sure, I was trying to think this the other day, I'm not sure that he ever wrote pieces strictly for brass. Brass instruments in his day were fairly rudimentary. They didn't have valves. The slides didn't work real well. And there was a limited number of notes they could play. They used trumpets some. French horns didn't exist in their current form, but natural horns were played a little bit. But I think this piece lends itself to brass, and I think you'll appreciate that when you hear the modern brass playing. Bach was not averse to taking other music and transcribing it, and so I don't think he would have a problem with us playing this on modern brass. For someone who can take a Vivaldi violin concerto and turn it into an organ concerto, I don't think he would have a problem with a choral prelude being played by brass. This next one, the Come Sweet Death, is a choral prelude, and I think you'll recognize it, but it, I think, lends itself very well. The next piece, Psalm 8, moves from one choir in our first piece to two brass groups in our second piece, and now to three separate brass groups, the main group and then two small groups on either side with that. This is also the same era that Gabrielli and Kuhnau were writing in, and I think you'll recognize the style. But I think it's interesting to see the progression from one piece to two groups to three groups and how it changes the sound.
Thank you.
any time it seems when someone wants brass or says, I'd like brass for this event, or could you play something brassy, or we just want to hear brass. What they're thinking of is fanfares. Fanfares are short pieces. They're almost show-off pieces for the trumpets or the other instruments, but they're very short, but they announce something's happening. And so fanfares is what you normally think of a lot of times when you're asking for brass pieces. The next group of pieces is a group of five fanfares. They're short. There'll be a break between each one. I have to let our timpanist tune a little bit between. For some reason, they didn't write all of these in the same key, and so he has to move from one key to the other on some of these. These pieces were written in 1890 for the Jubilee celebration of the composer Rimsky-Korsakov. And there's a set of five that I think show off the brass very well. One side note, there are various pieces that I can point through in my musical career that seem to inspire me to want to play the organ or fall in love with orchestral music or different things. And when I heard these pieces, these are the ones that made me fall in love with brass music. So I told the guys we were going to play them, and we were going to play all five of them because I just like them.
Thank you.
The last piece on the first half of our program is in the same style, but it's now a contemporary piece written by composer James Curnow. It harkens back to a prelude by Carpentier from the Baroque period, but it gives you a flavor of what a more modern fanfare now sounds like. It's not terribly atonal, but it does have a lot more modern flair than the previous one. This is the James Curnow Fanfare and Flourishes.
Thank you, guys, girls, ladies, gentlemen. You can see why festive occasions are done with brass. And the brass group has played for many different weddings over the years, and not the least of which was the marriage of Karen and Virgil Nielsen and Louise and Kimber Schneider. So we had a great time doing that. Now it's time for us to show our appreciation for the work that they continue. And as they get set up for the second half of the program, we're going to ask the deacons to wait upon us for an offering, and that will go to continue to support the Vesper programs and all that goes on here at the church in that regard. I'll have prayer and then we'll pass the plates, okay? Our Father, we thank you for the dedication of these men and women on stage. We thank you for the blessings that they bring to everyone whenever they play. May the funds that we give now go towards supporting all the Vesper programs and the work that we continue to do here at the University Church. Bless each giver, no matter large or small, and we give thanks for all of this in your name. Amen. While the deacons are taking up an offering, I would mention that next Sabbath at 5 o'clock, The Vesper program will be the Bellissimo Handbell Choir from Redlands Adventist Academy. They are a top-notch group, and if you were in church here this morning, you heard the two handbell choirs of the University Church, and it's quite an undertaking not only to have the young people play for church, but then for another group to come in and play for Vespers. There's a lot of moving around to do, and as you possibly saw this morning, there are bells that range from very small to extremely large. And the Redlands Adventist Academy has a wonderful reputation that goes along with handbell programs. So they will be next week. April 23, it'd be just slightly different. The Vespers will start at 6 o'clock that evening, 6 o'clock, and the Vespers on that afternoon and will be the Heritage Singers. So if you come early at 5 o'clock, you'll probably get a fairly decent seat. But the program starts at 6 on the 23rd. 5 o'clock next week, 6 o'clock on the 23rd. And we thank you for your continued support of the Vesper programs.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. One other person that I think Phil forgot to mention, but the horn player on the quintet, Ben Eby, is also another founding member of this group. Thank you, Ben. One of the great things that I enjoy so much playing with this group, and as Phil mentioned, it's been a few years since I've been playing with them. I was kind of looking around stage this morning, and four of my former directors are up here playing. I'm sometimes looking forward to being the fifth up there playing again. But it's a great group of guys and gals, and it's my privilege now to be directing some of my former directors. One of the unique things about this group is that although we're a brass group and we like to play the traditional brass music as well, we are integrally a part of the music program here at the University Church and view our primary mission as leaders of worship here at the church through our music. And so a lot of the things that we play in addition to the traditional brass music are hymn tune arrangements. And the last half of our program, as started by our quintet, is going to be some of these hymn tune arrangements. I'm not going to introduce them to you because I think you will recognize probably all of them. And if not, you'll know you've heard it someplace. But it's our privilege to be leaders of worship here and to play these marvelous hymn tune arrangements, and I hope you'll enjoy them as well.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us tonight. We have one final piece that I think you'll recognize again, but I wanted to thank you again for joining us and spending the last hours of the Sabbath with us tonight. The last one is a triumphal piece titled Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Thank you.
Before we have the benediction, I want to say on behalf of the congregation, the Vespers Committee, thank you for all the hours of rehearsal that I know went into this and every performance. And it's much, much appreciated. Today is Loma Linda Academy's reunion, and I would like to have the graduates of Loma Linda Academy, young and old, to stand, please, for just a moment. Just stand up if you went to Loma Linda Academy. Thank you, guys. And ladies and gentlemen, before we leave, give them another rousing round of applause. Eternal God, source of all beauty and harmony, we praise you for the gift of music, for the inspiration given to those who compose it, and for the skill of those who perform it, and for the faculties which enable us to enjoy it. I pray that all our lives have been enriched and renewed by today's music making, so that each of us may leave this house to glorify you and give thanks for all things through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you and good night.